And these are our goji berries. These are the ones that I did not like so much. And it grew really big.
Definitely an acquired taste. It's a lot sweeter than last year. Still kind of tastes like tomato-ish. I mean, it's not bad. I think it's one of those acquired tastes that'll take you a while to get used to it. But it's growing on me.
Do the sunset. Do in front of the sunset.
Is it sunsetting?
Yeah, look over there. Look over there. I said no. Stop. Why don't you listen?
Yeah, I got some over here. You gotta get rid of this green one. Don't harvest the green one. Except there's thorn on there. I think that's it, right?
Yeah. Well, that was our goji berry harvest for this season.
We still have a lot of goji berries. As you can tell, there's still some flowers in there. There's some green ones, so let's harvest some of these red ones. You can see there's still a lot more. And as you can see here, see those flowers and these little green ones? This will be ripening too. Okay, we got all of them for now, but you can tell there's still a lot more there on this side. And just so you guys know, these are very thorny. You can see these are thorns, so be careful when you're growing these. Oh, missed one right there. What we got for today. Yeah, look at here. We still have so much. So we're gonna harvest these. Oh yeah, that'll be good. Look at how much we got today. abundance of goji berries. And this bush is only 2 years old in the pot. This is its second year. We planted this last year. We got a little bit last year, but so far this year, we've harvested multiple times. And we have a lot more goji berries again. You can see. Harvest these. Okay, so this is what we got. We got about 2 cups here of goji berries. It's unbelievable that we're getting so much from this little bush right here in the pot that we planted last year. This is only its second year. And you can still see we still have a lot of them that's gonna ripen in the next few days, definitely by next week. So pretty sure I'm gonna come back here again 3 or 4 more times to harvest it. But this is what we got today. Unbelievable. Very prolific bush. I kinda like it. I think I'm gonna split that up somehow and plant some in the back over there so that we could double up on the harvest. And for some reason, the birds doesn't really hit it too much. Now the grapes that we have there and all the other fruits, the birds are attacking them. But here, they kind of leave this alone. For some reason, they don't like it. It is October 1st. It's a bit chilly out here and it's rainy. And tonight we're supposed to get our first frost. So we'll see what else I can gather from the goji berry, because I'm pretty sure the rest of them will probably be froze tonight. Okay, that's what we got today. It's decent. Like I said, there's more here. Frost might get them tonight. It's about 49 degrees right now. It's supposed to drop in the 30s tonight, so. And the ducks going away for the winter.
So there's actually a lot of goji berries. Well,
it's good.
My dad loves them.
Yeah, watch. They grow on me. Oh, so sweet. Try it.
Yeah.
Gotta give it a shot.
I'll try one. So since I'm trying to vlog and there's people over there, my dad is going to pick the raspberries and I'm going to continue picking the goji berries because I actually really feel like talking. My backyard neighbor is actually right there. She will probably hear me. But okay, so we have this thing to do. Some of here. Not many over here because my dad pretty much got all of them. But this is how much we have so far. Oh my god, this keeps poking me. Okay, let's just grab this. Yeah. By the way, oopsies. There's a lot of goji berries on the floor that have been dropped. Oh, my dad's back. There's a lot of goji berries on the floor that have been dropped. But now my dad is here because he finished doing the raspberries. Oh my gosh.
Oh,
there's so many goji berries on the floor that have been dropped.
Superfood.
We have this goji berry powder that we bought to put in like smoothies. But
I wonder if we're gonna get any.
We only eat that one.
A lot.
I think you saw the back of your head.
Okay,
so we finished, and this is the raspberries that he got. Actually, not at all. Not a lot at all. Anyways,
I'm gonna do the hose now because I really want to do the hose.
And here are all the goji berries.
It is January 1st, 2021. Happy New Year's, guys. And this is what the goji berries look like. I wonder if I have to trim this a little bit. It is January 24th, 2021 right now. And as you can see, this is our goji bush, and I'm not exactly sure, but I think I'm gonna trim this back so that it'll have a new growth for the season. So I think if I just let this be, it's gonna get really flimsy and fall. This is as you can see, it's a very thin growth. So I'm going to try to cut it back a little bit, and hopefully that would be a little bit better when it starts growing in the spring. I'm not sure what it will do, but it's kind of an experiment. Cut this back lower. So these are some of the ones that I've cut. So I wanted to show you. Very well alive. You see those? It's very green. It may look like it's dead, but you can see that. So nice, healthy branches. So I'm gonna go ahead and continue cutting at about that length. That one's a nice sturdy growth, so maybe try experiment and cut that a little bit higher. Some of these flimsier ones I'll cut lower. Okay, that's how I cut it. Most of it, the smaller ones, smaller twigs, I cut back more towards the pot. Shorter ones, and then some of the healthier, thicker ones I cut higher up. So that's kind of a more experiment to see how it will grow, and it'll teach me to determine for the next season of how I should be pruning. You can see that these are pretty healthy pencil thickness. I left that a little bit higher, so I'm kind of curious to see how that branches as when the new growth season starts. And some of the smaller ones I cut back. And those are the ones I cut. So we should see